Greetings everyone, welcome back to Voyager Adventures. I'm your host, Captain G, and in this video review, we're going to complete the second half of the Star Trek Voyager pilot, Caretaker, Part 2. So this episode starts on board Voyager, right near the Caretaker's Array. Captain Janeway is in her ready room, and Tuvok stops by to talk to her, discussing their options. We also learn that there's quite a bit of history between Captain Janeway and Tuvok. It seems that they've served together for a very long time. It was a really good scene that filled in the gaps and allows us to understand just how much Captain Janeway trusts Lieutenant Tuvok. Voyager ends up going to a salvage yard in the middle of space, not that far from the planet that the Caretaker is sending energy to. This is our first introduction to Neelix, who was less than thrilled and less than friendly, but he quickly got over that. I particularly liked how Neelix responded to the idea of being beamed, especially how he prepared himself before being beamed aboard Voyager. And then this epic encounter between Tuvok and Neelix was also all types of fun. It beautifully mirrors the differences in personality between the two characters. I also love that these differences continue to play out throughout the season and throughout the entirety of the series. In this scene, Harry Kim and B'Elanna Torres are getting to know each other. I liked how she called him Starfleet, and it was her kind of nickname for him. She's pretty suspicious of him at first until the first Okumpa shows up and tells them that they're free to walk around the complex. I overall liked the design of the underground complex that the Okumpa live in. This is one of my favorite shots that gives a good idea of the scope and size of the entire complex. In this next scene, they decide to hammer home the differences between Tuvok and Neelix. Tuvok stops by the guest quarters to find that Neelix has completely raided the replicator, so to speak, replicating multiple meals, multiple beverages, and as he goes to that forbidden zone, sees something that most people probably don't want to see, but we get to see it anyway, Neelix in a bubble bath. Overall, I found this scene to be very funny, very entertaining, to see the differences between Tuvok and Neelix. I remember thinking it was a little odd that Neelix was asking about water at the time when he was negotiating with Captain Janeway. At first I thought water being difficult to find was a little weird, but now it became very clear to me that he was potentially plotting and planning for this scene here where he takes them to the caisson. This scene right here is the very first scene that the Voyager crew has with the Kazon alien species, and I have to admit they were very underwhelming in scope. They could have been so much more ferocious, so much more dangerous, intimidating, but in reality, when I think of them, this is what I see. Oompa Loompas. Yep, they're large size Oompa Loompas. I don't know if anybody else has compared the two, but that's what I see when I see the Kazon. Giant Oompa Loompas. Of course, this is the scene where we eventually are introduced to Kes. We also see Janeway negotiating with the leader of the Kazon in an attempt to find a way down into the Okumpa settlement underground. It's then that we realize that Neelix had been plotting and planning Kes's rescue, and he holds the leader at gunpoint. And the rest of the Voyager crew grabs all their weapons and technology and quickly beams off the surface of the planet. It's in this scene we learn that B'Elanna and Harry Kim are trying to find a way to the surface. They do get the aid of an Okumpa woman who gives them medicine and also tells them where the tunnels are that could lead them to the surface of the planet. Now, the beginning of this scene is just classic. It really demonstrates how far the Doctor will evolve over time. Right now, he's treated like nothing more than a computer program, just a tool, and Janeway shuts him down real quick when he gets irritated. During the scene, Cass also decides to help the Voyager crew in finding their crew members and shows them the passage that she took to reach the surface. Now, this scene was important because Cass got to reunite with her people. You learn that they used to be far more self-sufficient. Now they're not. They're more dependent on the caretaker. In addition to that, you learn about their psychic abilities. You also learn that there's potential for more abilities down the line. Now, at this point, Tuvok decides to express his theory that the caretaker is in fact dying, which, of course, he is correct. This scene as a whole, I think, was very well done. It definitely helped express the urgency of the situation. Naturally, everybody gets reunited, and Kes helps them find a way through the barrier to get to the surface. At this point, they get separated, so Tom decides he wants to go back and get the rest of the people, including Chakotay, who at this point we've established he does not like him very much. Neelix decides to go with him too, and the rest of the people get beamed to safety. Of course, all the people left behind do get saved, including Chakotay, saved by Tom Paris. This is definitely key in helping them patch things up for the future. Now, at this point, the Kazon are converging on the array, as is Voyager and the Maquis ship. So at this point, a nice battle ensues over control of the array. I thought it made sense that the Kazon did not want the Voyager crew to have access to the array, simply out of greed, but also because they feared Voyager as well. While Janeway and Tuvok beam onto the array, the rest of the Maquis crew get beamed onto Voyager, and that leaves us with a pretty awesome shot of Chakotay making a suicide run right towards the Kazon ship, and of course beaming out at the last second. Very awesome scene, in my opinion. I really enjoyed it, and it says a lot about the kind of person Chakotay is as well. At this point, the array is starting to shut down, and the holographic simulation is shutting down as well, and we get to see the caretaker's actual form. He pleads with them to prevent the Kazon from boarding the array, because if they do, it's likely that they'll destroy the occupants, which leaves Janeway in a very difficult position. Janeway and Tuvok end up beaming back to Voyager, where they are currently already outgunned, and the Kazon have said that they already have more reinforcements on the way. So she makes the decision to destroy the array, to protect the occupants, and effectively stranding her and her crew 70,000 light years away from home. I honestly felt like this was the right call. I didn't really see any other way out of it, to be honest. They definitely weren't going to outgun the Kazon, especially with more ships coming, so that was probably the best option they had. Here in this scene, Tom Paris gets his field rank of lieutenant, which you can tell means an awful lot to him. His reaction is probably one of my favorite reactions of the entire episode. And here we have Kes and Neelix coming in as well, stating that they want to be members of the crew and to come along, which turns out to be very valuable for the Voyager crew to have them aboard. And the final scene where Janeway gives her speech about making new friends, some enemies, merging both crews, Maquis and Starfleet, into one crew, a Starfleet crew. And, of course, the beginning of their journey home. As a whole, I enjoyed this episode. It definitely had a lot more action in it than the first part. I will say that since it's part of a pilot, it did have the handicap of being stuck in the position to introduce a lot of characters, so I am giving this episode a carry-on rating. I think if the Kazon had ended up being a little more menacing, I would have given it a better ranking in my review. I hope you all enjoyed the video and also my thoughts on the episode. If you're interested in enriching your overall Voyager episode experience, I highly recommend checking out the podcast ran by Garrett Wang and Robert Duncan McNeil. The podcast is called The Delta Flyers. It is on Patreon. There is a free format that's just audio, but if you're on Patreon and decide to be one of their patrons, for a little extra money, you can enjoy bonus segments, as well as a video version of the podcast. They did release a video version on YouTube for the very first episode, so if you guys want to check that out, I'll leave a link in the description below. Thanks for watching, and be sure to subscribe for more videos.